Hi, in this video I want to show you how I created my font geometric using Illustrator and the plugin FontSelf. FontSelf offers a template to create fonts. I'm going to show you. This template makes use of several guides and is set up to get a very sophisticated font. My font is not that sophisticated, so I didn't use the template. What's important about the template are the guides, because although my font is not that complicated, I still needed the guides. I put FontSelf away. My font is based on this grid. It consists of 9 parts, and I added some quarters of circles to that. I drew these using smart guides to have exact snapping, and I used the arc tool. When the grid was set up for each of the letters, I used Live Paint to colorize all this. Now this is already a finished Live Paint group for the letter B. And the Live Paint cannot be used in FontSelf directly. It needs to be prepared. So the first step in this is to expand it. I'm using Illustrator in the latest version, and it has the Properties panel, which offers this expand button. Now, when this is expanded, it still is not ready for FontSelf because it's not optimized. I'm showing you. Ungroup this, and you see there are all small parts. Now, technically, I could use it as long as it's grouped, but there are too many points in it and too many paths. So let's use the Pathfinder on it. The Pathfinder panel, and let's first take a look at the options, which is important to remove redundant points. And now I can use just merge on it. Now you see it's grouped again. Let's ungroup it, and this is the result. 2 paths. These 2 paths need to be grouped. And this is how each letter needs to be prepared. And I've done that already. You see it in this range of letters. They are all in the correct order, and they are all aligned, which is also important. They need to be aligned at the baseline. Now let's go into FontSelf again. And it's simple from now on. I can just click this button, and FontSelf does the rest for me. It picks up all the letters and gets them in the correct order. Now in my font, the uppercase and the lowercase are the same, so I click this button to get the lowercase letters. And I've also got the numerals, and I just click 0 to 9. And now we've got numerals. Now at this stage, I can just install the font and give it a name. And now we have installed the font. Now let's test it. Enlarge this a little, and let's see. There is the font, which is okay, looks nice. But of course, it's missing some letters. Now, you can add and add and add. it's like a model railway, kind of. You can always add some new features. Now, of course, we need some commas and points. To align these, I need guides. In this comma, I want the baseline to be here. And to show this to FontSelf, I draw a line and make it into a guide. Just view, guides, make guides. And then select the comma as well. In the FontSelf panel, type the comma and create a glyph. Here we've got the comma. Now the point, create glyph as well. And somewhat FontSelf doesn't pick it up correctly, so I need to type the point, type return, and there we are. Another one, and create the glyph. And with this semicolon, again, I need the guide. So I drag it over there, select, now let's select the guide, select the semicolon, type the character, and create. Okay. Now I've got some other features. I want alternatives. I've got this letter O. Type letter O and create. Now FontSelf checks that there already is a letter O, so I can replace it if I want to, or I can say I want an alternative. So you see, there's my original O and there's the alternative. I can make another one. Letter O, create a glyph, and make an alternative. Now this one is a ligature. I also can do that. Type the letters and create a ligature. Now FontSelf asks me, and I want this to be a standard one. There we are. Now let's see how this looks. Here's my test text. And let's type the letter O. And it's like this. Select it. Okay. Let's first install it. I forgot to do that. So install it. Okay. And now you see Illustrator shows the alternatives I could use at this point. And I can replace it. Let's also see the comma and point, the semicolon. Everything is fine. Now, you probably know in German we've got all these crazy letters, like this one. I create a glyph for it. And what is new, this letter also exists as uppercase. And I can't even type it, but I can copy it from Wikipedia, copy that one, and then go to FontSelf, paste it in here, and create another glyph. What I need now is some refining. And to do this, I go into Advanced. I want to do some kerning. Now there are some pairs that will cause problems, the L and the T. To do that, I just type them in here, and now I can select the T and move this towards the left. Like this. Now that looks a lot nicer. I can do this for a lot of pairs and just change the kerning and go home again, and let's install this again. So I added a lot of characters to my font, but let's see some alternative styles for it. I also did those. First, I export this font to the desktop. It's already installed, and now I've got it on the desktop as well. And let's check the styles. I've made three alternative styles. One is called black. The other one is a light version, which is outlined. And I've got a fancy one with gradients. Now, this is just strokes at the moment, but I can use the stroked one directly in FontSelf. So all these characters are already in the correct order, and I just select them. Now I can make a new font, and I don't want a new font, but a new style for the family I've already got. Now, let's call this Other, and I want this to be light. And now just click the button, and FontSelf does the rest for me. And again, this button. And this is okay, I can export it. And the same goes for this other design. Just make a new one, a new style, and call it black. It's okay. Click the button, and FontSelf creates it. Now, this allowed me to do my font design really quickly, and it was just some awesome kind of work, and now I can add letters as I go along and just as I have time, you know, open these fonts again and just add the letters. So I can just go on open to get the regular version and then draw new characters for the font and add them to this design and then save it and test it. And just have fun with it.